My mum decided she was going to take me to London. Oui. I've never been to London before, and I remember being incredibly excited. We came up from the tube station, and the first place we went to was Covent Garden. Covent Garden amazed me straight away. The first thing I saw was a man dressed head to toe in silver who looked like he was floating. Then, a little bit further down, there was a man who was juggling, and then, in the corner, to me the most impressive, the magician. I watched him over and over again, and he did this thing where he had cups, and he moved the cups around, and when he lifted them, fruit would appear. I had no idea how it worked, and I watched it probably 8 times. That wasn't until my mum grabbed my hand and took me to all the theatres. She said, "You see that theatre over there? Well, tonight, for one night only, there's an illusion show. And we're going." And we did. So I went in the theatre and I sat kind of 3 rows from the front, like where you're all sitting. The man came out, did a few simple tricks, and then he asked for a volunteer. My hand instantly shot up, and to my amazement, he chose me. So now, 15 years later, that memory and that moment still plays in my mind. So I thought when creating this show, why not give one of you the same memory, the same moment that you can share with your friends and family forever. Kids, for the final time tonight, I'm looking at you. I'm going to choose you. Yeah, you'd be perfect. What's your name? I started doing more mind-based stuff. I guess with Darren Brown coming out, that sort of influenced my decision-making a little bit. So I worked at places like Madame Tussauds and the Sea Life Centre, but on Halloween, I got a call from the London Olympics. They invited me to do a select show for 50 people that would be in the far sort of east wing of the building. A little sort of isolated room. We had benches and the people came in and I began by showing them a film. A film with a mouth closed, a silent. Now kids, if you want to sit with your adults, you're more than welcome to, but I promise there's nothing scary and you're all going to be absolutely fine. So with that said, sit back, relax, it's fine, I promise. But let's change the mood. James Carabere was a surgeon, an amateur magician, and a strong believer in the paranormal. At a time where treatment was undergoing a revolution, James decided to adopt his own very peculiar and often barbaric techniques. He lived, worked, and studied in the confines of the Catalan Asylum in Jersey. Throughout his time inside the asylum, James operated and experimented on hundreds of patients. However, it was his last patient that drove him into despair. His last patient passed away the day before they were due to have an operation that James was convinced offered a permanent cure. James locked himself away and for nearly 3 months refused to release the body. James speedily became addicted to absinthe. He became a recluse and rarely, if ever, left his operating theatre. He would work incredibly long hours, normally through the night and always on his own. At the age of 48, through a startling turn of events, James ended up being operated on by inmates of the East Wing's ward. This was an operation that he never recovered from. The Catalan Asylum is now closed and remains desolate and disused. An auction was held in Guernsey almost a year after the asylum locked its doors for the final time. Many items were sold, including operating tables, gowns and books. Along with these items, a locked wooden box was put up for sale. The box was scratched and defaced and, interestingly, used to belong to James. The box was purchased at that very auction over the phone by an anonymous bidder.